it's clear, I think, from the studies that have been done so far, that this B.1.1.7 variant from the United Kingdom does spread more easily. A couple of big studies have been done now looking at transmission of this particular virus and the rate of transmission through community, and it seems to be much higher than some of the other strains that have been studied. There's good reason for it too, because again, when we look at the mutations, we see some changes with that spike protein that probably allow it to bind a little bit more efficiently. This is why variants become common in the first place, is because they have a mutation which allows them to be transmitted more efficiently. That's always a concern with variants. We know that with some other viruses, certain mutations or variants can lead to a more severe illness. Certainly, if you think about the flu, that's a common phenomenon where some strains of flu are much worse than other strains of flu. So that's a concern with some of these COVID variants, that they could result in more severe disease. That's not proven right now. There's a little bit of data from the United Kingdom which suggests that the B.1.1.7 variant there may cause a little bit more of a severe disease. If that's the case, it's probably a slight effect. The antibodies that are generated by more what we call wild-type virus infection may not bind as efficiently to some of these variants. And so there is concern that there might be an increased risk for reinfection. And that is something that is under active study for sure right now. Protecting yourself, it goes back to some of the fundamentals, right? So we've known from the beginning that one of the best ways you can protect yourself is through using the mask, wearing the mask, right? Make sure it's tightly fitted, that is covering your nose and your mouth, right? In order for it to be effective, being mindful about the isolation, the distancing, the hand hygiene, all those measures we know still work at protecting you from spread of infection. I will also say this, that the vaccines clearly play an enormous role. And I think, you know, sometimes I hear somebody say, well, I don't know about the vaccine. Now with these new variants, maybe the vaccine's not even gonna be as good a job. Well, anything's better than nothing. And we know that these vaccines are safe based on the large scale studies that have been done. And these vaccines can help prevent the emergence of variants. The more immunity we have in the population, the less spread of the virus we have, and the less opportunity for these mutations to arise in the first place. So getting a vaccine is actually a very significant part of helping to prevent variants from developing and spreading in the first place.